that one on video.
Apparently it doesn't understand out of the ditch.
Do I need to go push?
Yeah. Well, start a campfire.
I got half a cup of coffee and a chicken strip left. Okay, so I got shovels, toe straps, or what do you need?
I think maybe just pull back, we'll hook up, and then have you pull back and help get some traction up out of this ditch.
Do you want to come back down? Sounds like it. What if he airs down a little bit? Careful.
Oh, he might.
It's kind of slickery. Down a little. So what's the plan?
You mean to grab a strap or just give it a little tug, or you mean to? Okay.
There should be hooks right on the front there.
The toe strap that I have, roger that. I may have to either winch the front end out, the rear end out sideways, or get in front of you and pull you out of it that way, I think.
Okay, yeah, let me check these rocks over here in the left.
Whoa, a little deep over here.
Yeah.
I'm down over my knee.
Thank you. Oh yeah, yeah, that's synthetic. Yep. It doesn't hear. It doesn't have near the life of steel, but.
No, but using it.
Way easy, it's lightweight, doesn't kill your hands.
Yep. Doesn't poke holes in everything.
Yeah.
The strand breaks.
Yeah, if it snaps, it just kind of falls down. It doesn't take people's legs out. Steel can be dangerous if it snaps. But I think if they recommend if you use it just once or twice to replace it.
I think he's over controlling a little, but that's okay. About my rule of halves. Mm-hmm. So when you're flying an airplane, if you need to turn 30 degrees, if you turn and then you go, oh, there it is.
Oh, he's got off to the left there. I don't know if he's gonna. He's coming back out. Okay, go ahead.
By the time you roll out, you've gone way past 30 degrees. So you know, I gotta go back the other way, so you bank that way, and by the time you get rolled out, you're way past it again. Keep going past it both ways. So I came up with my rule of halves. So if you go halfway and halfway, you're almost there.
Yeah, driving a boat is a very non-precise thing like that, you know, too. You gotta be.
Yep, right up here, a little bit further. Yep, it's all flat now. I think I know which one he's talking about now. Still rolling. You got the whole thing of you getting winched out.
Oh, he asked that?
No, she did.
Oh.
Ghost 21.
Something to do with his army designation.
So who's in the upper left hand corner?
I don't know that. Gotten to explore lots of this hillside then.
This is the top of Cedar Tree to the left.
Oh, okay.
And that would go back all the way down.
Oh, I actually, where we stopped at on Cedar Tree last time was as far as I've been. I didn't realize Cedar Tree kept going.
Ron, where I went up and turned around, that's the last part of it.
Oh. Yeah, I guess I've never done the last part. I've done Cedar Tree like here. 3 or 4 times, but I've never done the last part, I guess.
I just realized I didn't get my nap today.
You typically, just on Sunday, you try to take a nap?
Yeah, because I go, as I get later and later in the week, Friday's almost my longest day. Saturday's my longest day, and then I get up and go to church on Sunday.
And especially when you serve, you got to be there early.
And then when I come home, I'll be sitting there watching TV, and then all of a sudden I'll wake up.
A couple hours later?
No, usually not more than 45 minutes or something.
Oh, you take some, okay. If I go to sleep in the afternoon like that, I sleep for a couple hours.
Yeah.
Couple.
Or if I went and laid down, I might be sitting there watching TV, and then all of a sudden I'll go, what's the last thing I remember? Still the same, where I'll be.